Looked down from a broken sky, traced out by the city lights, my world from a mile high.
My name is Dexter McCluster, and I'm here today to share my testimony and some things that I went through to bring me closer to Christ and closer to the Lord. Well, this summer, we were doing some Bible study. We try to do it at least once a week with our strength coach, Coach Don Decker, and Isaac. And one night, you know, I remember we sat down at a table, and he went around the table and asked all of us, you know, what's holding us from Jesus Christ, and what do you think is going to have to happen for you to get closer to the Lord? And the whole time before he got to me, I was listening to everybody's answer or response to that question. And when he got to me, you know, I looked at him and I said, as much as I hate to say it, something bad, something's tragic or major is going to have to happen to me in order for me to change my life, because I was used to so many sinful ways, and I would just, that's all I knew, and I got accustomed to doing it, and I did it every day, so something major had to happen for me to change. And Isaac looked at me and said, you never know, you know, you can be leaving here tonight, and can be driving down 6 and get into a car accident. And a couple of days later, you know, me, Greg Hardy, and one of our other friends, Billy Dobbs, we were going to the mall on a Saturday, just going to have fun, waste some time, just to joke around and just, like I said, just to have fun. And, you know, we spent some money. We were at the arcade. We rode a couple of the little kiddie rides in there, you know, just having fun, enjoying life. And on our way back to Oxford, to go back to Greg's house to record, you know, we were driving down 6, and I remember looking down at my phone and one of my teammates yelling out, what's going on? So I looked up at that moment, and it's like I seen a car coming full speed towards us. And at that moment, it's like time just literally slowed down like the movies. You know, you watch those movies and you see how those action-packed movies have scenes where it slows everything down and everything slows down until that big moment happens. And that's exactly how it happened to me. You know, time just slowed down. And I had a chance to think about, you know, all my loved ones, my mom, my dad, my uncles, cousins, and especially my 3-year-old daughter. And I realized at that moment, you know, it was nothing I can do about it. You know, we're about to get hit. And at that moment, we got hit. We got thrown off the road, and the car struck fire immediately. And we were all able to get out. But, you know, at that moment, you know, I wanted to call my daughter and just to hear her voice and let her know, you know, that how much I loved her, and I needed to run back to the car and get my phone. So I was on fire. I actually ran to the car. And I didn't know where my phone had fell during the wreck, but I know the Lord brought me straight to it. I picked my phone up, I called my family, and I told my mom what had happened. And you know, I was crying, my mom started to cry, and it was just a very emotional moment. And I asked her to put my daughter on the phone, and you know, I just started smiling and just let her know that I love her, and every day I'm gonna call her and you know, let her know I love her. And the car was burnt completely. We lost everything in there. Clothing, keys, just everything we brought with us. But, you know, I'm thankful that I escaped out of it with my life, and I'm sure those other guys can say the same thing. And, you know, that Sunday, we went to church together just to, you know, thank the Lord for us still being here. And I remember the pastor singing a song that really brought tears to my eyes and, you know, brought tears to all of our eyes. And at that moment, you know, I dropped to my knees and I told the Lord that, you know, I need you, Lord. I can't do it by myself. I want you to come into my heart and make a change in my life. And, you know, from that day on, you know, I've been living a Christian life. I've been trying to do my best to influence younger kids or whether it be adults, you know, to just live life right. And, you know, coming out of the accident, you know, I was wearing this cross on my neck. And I never really wore it before this day. It just so happened I had it on. And since I wore it during the wreck and I escaped out of it okay, you know, I wear this every day just to remind me of how blessed I am. And I wear this as my shield, sort of like my bulletproof vest. You know, I wear it everywhere I go. And I want to close right now by reading a passage out of the Bible. And it's from Luke chapter 15, verses 4 through 7. What man among you, if he has 100 sheep and has lost one of them, does not leave the 99 in the open pasture and go after the one which was lost until he finds it. And I'll stop right there. You know, I was that sheep, you know. I was one of many, and I was astray. I was lost. I needed the Lord. And he goes on to say, and when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and his neighbors, saying to them, rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep, which was lost. I tell you that in the same way, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who need no repentance. So the reason I close with that, you know, I was lost. You know, I didn't know which way to go. And, you know, I said something major and something tragic is going to have to happen. And the Lord made that happen. And he opened my eyes. And, you know, I just want to let everybody know that no matter what the situation is, no matter how bad of a sinner you might think you are, you know, the Lord will forgive you. He loves you, and he will come after you and love you just as much. So I want to thank y'all for listening to my testimony. I'm Dexter McCluster. Give me your heart, Lord, give me your eyes.